Hello guys, in this video we're gonna speak about the rules of the impulsive waves, but as a small introduction I want to mention that the impulsive wave is apart from the motive waves, and there are other kinds of the motive waves like the leading diagonal and the ending diagonal. But today's lesson is about the rules of the impulsive waves. You know that the impulsive wave is the most common shape of the waves in Elliott waves method, which consists of five waves like that, and there are some laws that arrange this impulsive wave. And there are the diagonals, which looks like a normal wedge or an extended wedge like that. So we have a multiple shapes of this mode of waves, and now we're gonna speak about the impulsive waves. So here, as you can see, we have the shape of an impulsive wave that includes its subwaves from the lower degree, like we spoke in the last lesson. And from the left of the page, we can see that there are some rules. The first rule is about the internal structure of the impulsive wave, which says that this wave consists from five waves. There are two waves that are corrections and three waves that are also emotive waves. Wave two and wave four are corrections, and wave one and three and five are motive waves. The second rule says that wave 2 cannot exceed the point that represents the beginning of the wave 1, even with one pip. This rule is very strict. The third rule, which I already mentioned, that wave 2 and wave 4 are corrections. The wave 1 and 3 and 5 are also motive waves. The wave 2 can be in certain corrections, and the wave 4 can be also in a certain corrections. When we see the laws of the corrections, we'll know which pattern emerges in the wave 2 and which pattern that emerges in the wave 4. The fourth rule says that the wave 1, as it can be also an impulsive wave that is arranged by the same laws that I'm saying right now, or it can be in a diagonal shape, which is apart from the motive waves, like I said, whether a normal wedge like that or an expanded wedge that looks approximately like that. We'll see the details about the diagonals in the next lesson. The fifth rule, which is pretty common too, which says that wave 1 and wave 4 don't overlap, which means that the wave 4 cannot push the price to go to the price range of the wave 1. We have also a rule that says wave 3 should be only in an impulsive wave shape, which means that it's not like the wave 1 where we can see diagonal or an impulsive wave. This wave should be just an impulsive wave. We cannot see a diagonal as a wave 3, like for example a wedge like that where there is some subwaves that make an overlap. No, we should see just an impulsive wave in the wave 3. And this wave, it cannot be the shortest between the wave 1 and the wave 5, which means that it can be shorter than the wave 1, it can be shorter than the wave 5, but it cannot be shorter than both. And usually, it's the longest wave in the whole structure. There is also a rule that the majority neglected, which says that wave 3 should push the price beyond the point that represents the end of the wave 1. Why I'm saying that? Because you see some counts from some people where they make a count like this. They say this is wave 1, this is 2, and this is 3, and this is 4, and this is 5. You tell them this is wrong. You tell them why. They say, look, wave 2 didn't go beyond the beginning of the wave 1. Wave 3 is not the shortest. It's true that it's shorter than the wave 1, but it's not shorter than the wave 5. So what's wrong in our count? So as you can see, the wave 3 should push the price beyond the point that represents the end of the wave 1. And it has a certain ideal length according to the guidelines of Fibonacci, which we will see them in a specific lesson in this free course. The next rule says that wave 5, as it can be an impulsive wave, it can be also an ending diagonal pattern, like the wave 1, which means that we can see an impulsive wave like this in this picture, and also it can be a diagonal pattern, either in a wedge pattern, normal wedge, or an expanded wedge. But we have to be careful here. If there is a leading diagonal in the wave 1, we should not see an ending diagonal in the wave 5, which means that we cannot see two diagonals in the same impulsive wave in the same degree. We saw the degrees in the last lesson, which means that, for example, if we have a leading diagonal in the wave 5 from the wave 1, which is the impulsive wave in the lower degree, it's a normal thing to see an ending diagonal in the wave 5 in the bigger degree. We have diagonal in the wave 5 and diagonal in the wave 1, but they are not in the same degree. This rule says that we should not see two diagonals in the same degree. For example, if this wave 1 and this wave 5 are both diagonals, then this is wrong. There must be something wrong in our count and we should adjust it. But if there is two diagonals in this big impulsive wave, but they are not from the same degree, for example, leading diagonal in the wave 1 from 3 and an ending diagonal in the wave 5 in the bigger degree, this is completely normal. But if there is a leading diagonal in the wave 1 from 3 and an ending diagonal in the wave 5 from 3, then this is wrong. This rule says that we should not see two diagonals from the same degree. That's it. Let's see an example from the chart of the Bitcoin, where it used to be between 8,000 and 9,000, where we saw an impulsive wave started with a leading diagonal pattern, which we will see its rules in the next lesson. And then we have wave 2 and then wave 3. As you can see, the wave 3, it's the longest wave. And the subwaves of the wave 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the wave 3 is the longest between the wave 1 and the wave 5 from the same degree. We have only one diagonal pattern in this impulsive wave that represents wave 3. Wave 5 is a diagonal, but wave 1 was an impulsive wave. Wave 2 is not breaking the beginning of the wave 1. Even from the lower degree, wave 2, this red wave 2, didn't exceed the point of the wave 1. Wave 3 always pushes the price beyond the point that represents the end of the wave 1. If you can notice here that we are changing the color, the size, and the way we write the numbers that represent the waves from a different degrees. And this is in order to make our count neat, organized, and tidy. So that's it for this lesson. If you have any questions, you can put them in the comment section, and I'll see you in the next video.